Now here to give us her insight on the news of the week is Sophie McNeill from Triple J's Hack Program. Sophie, great to have you with us.
Thank you.
No doubt about the big story of the week, it had to be that little royal baby.
Oh look, it drove a lot of people crazy. You know, if you're not a fan of the royal family or if you just think there's more important things going on in the world, you couldn't escape it at all. So I quite like what the Guardian newspaper did this week. They had this nifty little button in the corner of their website called, it says Republican there. You can just click on it and all the royal coverage disappeared. I also really like what the British satirical current affairs magazine Private Eye did. This was their front page on Wednesday morning. Woman has a baby. That's it. It was as simple as that.
Absolutely. Not overselling it by any means. Now, of course, Private Eye is its own satirical outlet, but Twitter is everyone's personal satirical outlet, and
yes,
people went to that.
People had a lot of fun this week with the royal birth. These are some of my favourite tweets from the week. One way of breaking the fact that it was a boy, royal baby born with crown jewels. I thought this was pretty clever. And, you know, this is a bit mean with the ashes going on in the UK at the moment. If the royal baby was Australian, it would be out by now.
Hate it when the POM's going to laugh at our expense. Of course, the other big policy story of the week was asylum seeker issues. That's also being well worked over.
Yeah, it's been going on for quite a few weeks now, and it did feel that this week it really reached a pinnacle. You had both sides of politics really trying to outdo each other, just promise one more extreme thing after another. Who knows what's going to work, what will stop the boats if they can be stopped. But what was interesting was when the Immigration Department came under a lot of criticism when they released photos to try and promote the government's new policy to send people to Papua New Guinea, and these photos were of Iranian asylum seekers. This is apparently a young Iranian woman, and the Immigration Department says she has just found out she's not coming to Australia. She's being sent to Papua New Guinea. And some people question whether that was correct to use these images in that way, and the Asylum Seeker Resource Centre in Melbourne certainly didn't think so, and they put out this tweet saying, disgusting, the Immigration Department posting pics of distressed asylum seekers to be sent to PNG like some kind of trophy. So that was quite controversial that this week, Hugh. And another photo that really stood out for me this week in relation to the asylum seeker story was this photo. This is a 3.5-year-old. His name is Baramithan Balamunaran, and he was on a boat on Tuesday night. It sunk off the coast of Java. 189 people were rescued. Unfortunately, the 3.5-year-old Baramithan wasn't. He was one of 13 people who drowned. And we don't often get to see the personal stories behind these asylum seekers. A lot of politics, a lot of debate, a lot of emotion this week, but here's one photo that I don't think I'm going to forget for a long time.
Yes, a face to a continuing tragedy. In the face of all of this, a reaction from one famous Australian on Twitter.
Yes, Russell Crowe, I don't know what he was reacting to specifically, but he put out a plea this week to the world on Twitter. He wants Malcolm Turnbull in charge. He said, "Dear Malcolm Turnbull, I'm a union member, a taxpayer. You're the most trusted poly in our country. Destiny calls. Please consider." So I don't know if Malcolm Turnbull is going to take the political advice of Russell Crowe. He got back to him pretty quickly on Twitter and said, you know, "Cheers, Russell, thanks. You're very generous to your local member." But he didn't rule anything out. And Russell also confessed later that he can't actually vote because he's not an Australian citizen. He's just a permanent resident. He's a Kiwi. So, yes.
Yes, and spends a lot of his time in the US, of course, as well. Sophie McNeill from Hack on Triple J. Thank you very much for joining us tonight.
No worries.